Welcome to Phonetics Lesson 2. In this lesson, we will discuss modes of phonation and manner of articulation. The vocal folds play a primary role in producing sounds for language. The different actions of the vocal folds are referred to as modes of phonation. There are four principal modes of phonation in the world's languages. However, we will be mostly concerned with the first two here. The first mode of phonation is actually a lack of action on the part of the vocal folds. They are partially open, allowing relatively unrestricted passage of air. They are not, however, fully open as during normal breathing. Sounds such as f as in feel, s as in sink, and t as in tall are all voiceless. When the vocal folds vibrate rapidly, they produce a voiced sound. You can feel a distinct vibration on the Adam's apple when you produce a voiced sound. This is referred to as modal phonation. You can feel vibration on your Adam's apple. Ah. Contrast a voiced sound such as Z, Z, with a voiceless sound such as S, S, Z, Z, Z. You'll notice with the voiced sound, you'll feel vibration on the Adam's apple, but with the voiceless sound, you will not feel any vibration. The frequency of the vibrations is measured in cycles per second, or hertz. The average frequency for speaking is 265 hertz for children, 225 hertz for adult women, and 120 hertz for adult men. When Chosumi sings the high F in her famous aria in The Magic Flute, her vocal folds are vibrating at 1,397 hertz. Other modes of phonation include breathy voice and creaky voice. In modal phonation, the folds close completely between each cycle. With breathy voice, the vocal folds do not close completely between each cycle. And with creaky voice, the vocal folds are compressed tightly, giving rise to a drop in pitch. Let's move on now to different manners of articulation. This refers to different ways the airflow is obstructed in the vocal tract. You may find it useful to follow along the IPA chart at this point. Pause the video now to go get the chart and read along the column on the left-hand side. We will start by introducing some of the symbols found on the IPA chart to get you used to them. The first manner is stop or plosive. With plosives, airflow is completely stopped along the oral tract and then released. Common stops include p, b, t, d, k, and g. Consider the following words: spin, bin, stove, dove, pool, tak. In these examples, just consider the consonants for now. We'll look at vowels later on. Note that the symbol for the voice stop representing the g sound is a printed g rather than a typewriter g. Here you can see it in the word guess. Fricatives involve airflow that is tightly constricted along the oral tract. Airflow is continuous but highly turbulent. The most common fricative is S, S. Other fricatives include F, V, Z, and Sh. An affricate involves airflow that is completely stopped but then is released slowly. Compare the plosive T with the affricate Ch. Both English and Korean have affricates. Compare the English words to and chew, as well as the Korean words to and cho. Nasal stops involve airflow that is completely stopped along the oral tract, but with the vellum lowered, allowing passage of airflow through the nasal cavity. Compare the English words be and me. Be begins with an oral stop or a plosive. Me begins with a nasal stop. Lateral fricatives are less common, but they do appear in a variety of languages around the world. A lateral fricative is essentially the same as a fricative, but the air passes out the side of the articulator rather than out the front. Here is an example from the Dravidian language Toda.
Kal, 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 kal.
Next is the trill, in which airflow causes an articulator to pass repeatedly over a surface. A well-known trill is the R sound, rrr, found in several Romance languages, including Portuguese, Spanish, and Italian. Flaps and taps are similar to trills, however, the articulator passes over the surface only once. Korean has a flap in the word autumn. Many varieties of English have flaps too, as in the word butter. Note that Spanish contrasts the trill with the flap, as in the word perro, meaning dog, that has a trill, and pero, which means butt, which has a flap. Finally, we have approximants and lateral approximants. Both involve airflow with only slight turbulence. The turbulence is not enough to cause an audible sound, but is enough to alter the flow of air and sound waves enough to cause a change in the quality of the sound. Approximants are commonly divided into glides and liquids. Glides have a corresponding vowel, whereas liquids do not. Compare the English words zip, lip, rip, and whip, where zip begins with a voiced fricative, lip begins with a lateral approximant, which is also a liquid, rip begins with an approximant, which is also a liquid, and whip begins with an approximant that is a glide. Note that in the speech of some speakers, the word whip is articulated with a voiceless approximant, as in whip. English has a two-way distinction for many consonants. They are either voiced or voiceless. Concentrate on the initial sounds in the following words. Try to find the initial sound on the IPA chart. Notice that when the sounds appear in pairs on the chart, the symbol on the left is voiceless and the symbol on the right is voiced. The following words all begin with voiceless sounds. Pet, tan, cool, fine, sip, thin. Now, the following words all begin with voiced sounds. Bet, dan, ghoul, vine, zip, them. Korean has a three-way distinction for many consonants. They are either lenis, aspirated, or fortis. The lenis consonants are sometimes called plain. Aspiration refers to a delay in the onset of voicing after the release of the consonant, giving rise to an audible puff of air. The plain consonants have a slight aspiration for many speakers, especially in the sole variety. Note also that the aspirated consonants trigger a higher pitch on the following vowels. Compare the spectrograms for the words tal and tal. Notice the short aspiration for the plain consonant and the long aspiration for the aspirated consonant. Notice also that the vowel following the aspirated consonant is much higher in pitch, 274 Hz to compare to 231. The fortis consonants have been tricky to define in precise phonetic detail, partly because it is difficult to see exactly what the glottis is doing during speech. Nevertheless, we do know that the Korean fortis consonants are released with greater air pressure than the plain or aspirated consonants. They also involve increased glottal pressure, but the precise details are still a matter of ongoing research.